So this is some of the fun stuff that you can do with your DJI Air 2S, doing all these quick shots. And they look pretty cool right out of the box. But the drone is capable of doing so much better. What if you have recorded some 4K footage and you really want that to pop? In this video, I will show you how easy it is to apply a LUT to your footage and make it really stand out. Skillshare is the sponsor of this video. The Air 2S is a very capable drone that can record up to 5.4K in 30fps. And you can record in various formats with the drone. Recordings with the normal format is recorded in 8-bit, and there are certain limitations to what you can do with footage that is recorded in 8-bit. But that doesn't matter because DJI took care of all the color grading and the adjusting of the clip. So the idea behind the standard profile is basically that you can use the footage directly off camera on social media. If you want to get more out of your footage, you need to use the two additional color profiles that are provided, the D-Log M and the HLG. What happens when you shoot in D-Log M is that the colors are being very flat and desaturated. And the reason for that is that we can squeeze a lot more information into the footage. Actually, we can get up to 12.5 stops of dynamic range. And maybe that doesn't say anything to you, but that's a lot. So that will definitely preserve much more of the highlights and the dark areas of the footage if you use the D-Log option. The HLG option, I won't cover that here in this video, but I will tell you that this is basically the same as HDR, so it will be possible to shoot HDR footage by using the HLG format. It requires some additional steps to make that footage look nice, which I could cover in a separate video. But for now, we'll just concentrate on the D-Log M. Before we jump into Final Cut, that is my preferred tool of editing, I want to say thank you to Skillshare, that is the sponsor of this video. If you don't know Skillshare, Skillshare is an online learning community that, much like Netflix, through a low annual subscription fee, will offer you access to more than 20,000 courses. On Skillshare, there is a lot of stuff that you can start digging into, from enhancing your photos, how to make better compositions with your camera, and even how to edit your videos. I've learned a lot by watching these courses, and I published a few courses on that platform as well. It's super cool, and the annual subscription is as low as $10 a month. But you know what? The cool part is that you can dig into this as well for free, as the first 1,000 that click the link in the description below will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. The technique is pretty simple. What we're doing is we are taking our footage, we put it on the timeline, and then we apply something that's called a LUT. A LUT is also short for lookup table, and that's basically a definition how the colors should be adjusted to this clip to bring back the colors. That would mean from the flat and desaturated image, you will just by a few clicks be able to get the colors so they are really, really nice. There is one thing that I want to clarify here, which is often misunderstood when you're talking about changing colors on your footage. There's color correction and there's color grading. Those are two different things. Color correction is what you do to your footage to bring it back to a neutral color space, often called Rec. 709, where the colors are absolutely neutral, meaning that white is white and black is black and gray is gray and so forth. Color grading is something that you usually put on top of this to add like an artistic look to your footage. You would know that if you have seen movies like Transformers and so, where they use this orange teal look that will sort of make it very easy to recognize that the footage originates from that movie. But that is normally something that you add on top of your corrected footage. Before we jump onto Final Cut to check that out, we need to get this LUT. The D-Log M to Rec. 709 LUT that you need, you could go to the Tech Drone Media website where I made a download link available through the description below. So the next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna define a project here. And for this case, we will do a 5K project and we will simply call it DJI Air 2S. It's not a 2S sample video. And we will keep it at 2997p and it's in 5K resolution. Now we have a blank timeline and I go into my library here. Now we scroll down here I know I have some pretty nice images, a pretty nice footage that I recorded from the castle of Kronborg. That could be in this section. So let's just see here. So I have, let's just pick some nice footage here. So I'm just scrubbing here. So let's just take this, the launch sequence here. Maybe it's better from here. Like that. And I put that on the timeline. Let's just expand the timeline a second here. That's a lot of expanding. So, like that. And then let's pick one more from the castle here. We're doing like a nice point of interest. So, now I selected two clips in D-log-M and added them to my timeline. What do you think about the footage that they can be generated with the DJI Air 2S? Let me know in the comment below. The next thing that I'm gonna do here is I'm going to fold out this menu here, and then I'm going to search for custom LUTs. I select all here, and then I get the option custom LUTs, and I can take this LUT and drop it onto both of the clips. So once you have downloaded the LUT from the website, either from the DJI website or for the Tech Drone Media website, then and have added this custom LUT on top of your clips, the process is pretty simple. I've done it before, so of course it's in the list here, but if I hadn't done it before, I simply had just had to go down here and press choose custom LUT and simply browse to the location where the file was located, and it's called with the extension .cube, then you know it's the right file. And you simply select it, then it will appear in this list next time you work with this custom LUT layer. So the process of getting LUTs into at least Final Cut is very, very simple. LUTs are universal, so they can be used in all the other software platforms as well as Adobe Premiere and DaVinci Resolve or whatever other professional tool that you're using. So what you would see here in the inspector, now I get the chance to select a LUT that I can add on top of my footage. So if I just pick this one of the castle here and select the clip, I can go up here, and in the list I have a lot of different LUTs available. The one that I installed prior to this is the D-Log-M to Rec 709. And if I just press that one, you can see that the colors are really coming to life. So let's just do it on the other one as well. You can see the difference here. Maybe what I should actually have done is I take this one off and then I cut it in half like this. And then we will add the LUT here on the last clip. So now you can see the difference. Look at this. Just by adding this LUT, I can make the colors really pop on the footage. And of course you can adjust the magnitude of the LUT. A LUT is not a one shoe fits all. You need to adjust it a little bit so it fits to your needs once it's applied. Let's just make the same exercise over here. And then take this one and add the Rec 709. Baf! Now you're getting these really nice punchy colors that you see all over the place. So D-Log-M as the baseline with a LUT on top of it can really do something to your footage. And as I mentioned before, I can add another LUT on top of this. And then I have at some point purchased the orange teal look from Javen Dovey. So if I add that on top of it, so now I have the D-Log-M, which brings the colors to the Rec 709 color space. And on top of that, I put the orange teal. So now I get the orange teal look of the footage. But this is how you basically alterate your footage from your DJI Air 2S or any other drone that is capable of doing the D-Log format. Do you want more editing tips like this? Then let me know in the comments below. And I really hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, then feel free to give it a like. If you didn't like it, feel free to press the dislike button twice. Thank you for watching, and I'll be seeing you around.